My lead is very subtle. I do not want to manipulate the lady around the floor. If she knows the step, she's not going to follow me. And she's going to do what she knows she's supposed to do. But if you know to follow my position with the hand, you do it. If the lady knows what to do with the position of the hand, she's going to follow that hand. I don't care what she thinks the step is, and eventually she'll do what I want her to do. So, no, my lead is not bad. It really is about ladies understanding. Gentlemen, it's not out here to tell you what to do. It's to ask you to do what you want you to do. What happens if they do what they want to do?
Yeah.
I am fine. I don't know what she's going to do, but if she just does what she wants to do, I'm just going to make something happen. We're going to dance. I'm just going to do whatever I have to do. Here's a philosophy I have with basically all forms of dance. The gentleman leads, and he follows. I have to do whatever she's going to do. If it isn't what I've asked, I say my lead is not bad. Well, she doesn't follow my lead, is that it? True. Because I have to adjust to what the lady did. I have to adjust to what her training is. I remember one time, this is early on in my teaching career, I had somebody advance with a lady, let's say we're just doing this nice little six-step turn. She just won't do the six-step turn. Regardless, I mean, I even tried to force her to do it. I tried to tell her, you know, just keep going. Keep going. Okay, good. And then I'm exaggerating right now. And she said, you know, I know you want me to do something. What do you want me to do? I said, I just want to do a simple, you know, I don't remember this. Six-step turn. Okay. Probably wasn't that good. And I said, I was just trying to get you to do six-step turn. She says, but you can tap on my shoulder three times. That's how she was taught with all the beliefs. So did I become a bad leader then? Yeah, because I didn't know what her signal was. I'll take the responsibility. But the issue is, I always want to take that philosophy that I am inviting the lady to do something. If she doesn't do it, I have to follow her if she does. Gentlemen, I think it's important that you follow that philosophy. You will have ladies answer much more that way than you try to get to the right answer. I don't think any lady likes to be answered.
Other half was comparing this cross-body to something that's not a cross-body beat like that.
What's cross-body beat?
It's different.
Yes, it is. And it's exactly right. It's different.
If you guys want this other slide, you should get in trouble.
Well, and here again, it's kind of the idea of what I'm asking the lady to do. Cross-body beat, what is the philosophy of cross-body beat? I want to go in an opposite direction, yes? And it could be a quarter turn. Be a half turn, yes? In this particular situation you're talking about is you're going from a closed position to an open position.
Yeah.
You're going side by side. Okay. If I'm dancing this in rhythm, typically all I'm doing is I'm asking the lady to take forward steps. We'll just stick with it. Alright? And she's continuing to go forward until she can't anymore. And that was my philosophy in regards to the lead. At a certain point, she can't go that direction anymore. She's walked into her arm. So what is your choice? You have to turn. It's the only thing you can do. But if she waited to do that, when she runs into it, this turn is much quicker. If she knows the step, it's slower. And that's why I like the idea of just creating that lead for you to dance into my arm. Okay? So I think in terms of the rhythm style, that is the proper action. International?
Yes.
So if I'm dancing the international crossbody, I'm going to ask her to dance right into me. So she's actually taking this first step right into my knee. Yeah? So the difference here is actually where I'm leading the the lady before I get out of the way. So it's a quicker action than the international style. But it's basically the same idea. I still want her to run out of the dance. So she's coming right at me. I get out of her way. She steps past me. And depending upon what I'm going to do, whether I'm just going to take a side step and send her away or dance with her. Unfortunately, most guys, they have a hard time knowing what they're supposed to do. that's why you end up in many cases with so many bad ones. But no, in general, I teach the guys that first things you have to do it more. And frankly, what I find happens is if you have good quality girls, they learn the guys' thing. And then they extrapolate so they know what the girl step is before I teach it. So it always goes well with the girls. Not always. That's when you start getting the complicated stuff. But in general, since you're rearing a good guy, there's most of that you can figure out, right? When we start getting into tumble turns and that kind of thing, then maybe not so much. Why did I say that? There was a reason I said that. I'm sorry, but I knew I was heading somewhere over that statement, but I forgot where it was. The idea really is it's just, yeah, my leads need to be subtle. I want the ladies to be able to dance. That's where I'm saying. There's only so much I can think about. I want to dance me, and I'll create a nice lead for the lady, but I gotta worry about where she's going and how she's getting there. Think about it. It now takes focus, energy. If I've got to make you go where I want you to go, I'm now losing the energy I can put into the step on my phone. Yeah? If I just let her dance, it doesn't matter if she even does what I want her to do, but if I can create a lead and just let her dance, it's going to look better. So don't make me manipulate the lead. And with the, yeah, the ladies are kind of much more fun. She may get out of the floor and wonder what the hell she just did. All right, anything else? Okay. Thank you all. I hope you got something.
Thank you.
I certainly enjoyed doing this. I hope